morning, everyone. Jerry Hawk 250 here. I'm on my morning commute to work. Yep, everybody else is staying home, but we have to work today. We're working on hospitals and jail, and because of that we have to come in, make sure these jobs get done. I've been taking my new bike in, my Venom X22R 250, since Monday. That's what I got this bike for, was to commute back and forth to work. I got a few more people on the road this morning compared to yesterday. It was dead. I think I ran into two cars on the way going to work. That's crazy. Gas. $1.82 a gallon. That don't help our economy here. Yeah, it's nice on your pocketbook when you fill up, but South Louisiana, that's what we run on. Petroleum. This coronavirus thing don't help things out. Well, at least they had no fog this morning. Monday I left here, it was kind of nice, but boy, man, it got thick by the time I got to work. I had to ride my shield open because it was just fogging up and water was actually dripping off of it. But yeah, I'm back, took my bike here. I love it. Got my speedometer all calibrated now, and of course I'm speeding now. Just installed a PE30 carb on it. This bike got it dialed in. I'm still running a tad rich on my pilot jet. Had to order some more jets because I didn't have one small enough. Yeah, you'll notice that when I in idle, it kind of, you can tell it's running rich. It's kind of chugging a little bit. Dark 30 for me. It's an everyday routine, well, 5 days a week routine. Got my new mirrors installed. These are a much nicer than the ones I had on here. The ones that came with it, they just wouldn't stay in place. One of them actually vibrated and rattled. Dark. Oh yeah, I'm recording. noticed something. I was like, you see my lights flickering? They're hooked up to, well, you have to have an ignition on, actually, I guess, working off the alternator or magneto or whatever you want to call it. I want to hook them things up with directly to the battery. I turn the ignition on, or hook them to the ignition. I turn the ignition on, the lights come on. Or put another switch in where I can turn them off and on. Lights like to change on me right when I get to them. This lower gear ratio, collar room gear ratio. I'm gonna cruise along 55 right now and barely turning on 5,000 RPMs, just a little over 5,000. Different route to work, but on that road, there are some bumps in the road that when it's dark, you really don't see them right away. If you don't know exactly where they're at, you hit them, and they're pretty bad. Well, I'd rather come this way, and it takes me just a tad bit longer, but not much. In the afternoon, I'll drive back the other way, because it's daylight, I can see. The bumps. But yeah, I really like the bike. Except for us. Hope this all passes quick. It's pretty bad in New Orleans area. That's where most of the cases are. Have somebody get some concrete this morning? Probably one of our Yep, she killed on me. Yeah, I got a Jetson. She come in this weekend. I can tune that low speed. Thought I had it dialed in. Pretty good. That might have been maybe 3/4 throttle. It didn't have to even open it up. That first week and a half though, it ran, you know, decent, but it needed some work. Got the catalytic converter out, and that's a big improvement. Changed this rear sprocket, tuned the car, and I bought this PE30. Open house and do my head work, you know, porting and decking the head. And I said, well, I'm gonna try it out to see how it works. And I improve it on the stock end. And, well, yeah, it is. It really is. So I can't imagine what porting and decking the head will do to this bike. LED lights, headlights, much better than the stock. Of course, the stock ones on here were much better than when I came home, because them things didn't line up anything at all. And I realized I had my brights on, blinding everybody. Reason why I don't know why the car didn't see me back there. Yeah, my usual route, I think the main highway, which is a 70 mile an hour. That was the reason I was looking for a good street bike. I want to be able to get on the interstate and run for a little ways. Short ride. I got about a 12-mile trip. Ain't too bad. But instead of cranking up my big old V8 and my Ram, which gets pretty good gas mileage, but from 21 miles a gallon going to 60, say at least 65 average on this bike, yeah, a big difference. I'm still running the same gas that I put in Sunday before this past Sunday. So over a week. This is my third trip to work with it. It's still marking full, and I check it. I probably got 3/4 of a tank of gas because I don't trust the gauges. They're not super accurate. Which I think I can probably adjust that later on if I have to pull the tank off. It does get close to empty, it does show empty. Yeah, the small sprocket does give it, you know, good top end cruising range, you know, the engine's not screaming. Yeah, even at 80 miles an hour, it's not even quite turned 8,000 RPMs, which, you know, is where the power range on these bikes, you know, between the 7 and 8,000 RPMs. That's where this engine produces the most power. So that's where you want to get your bike geared to. At the speeds you want to ride. If I wanted to ride off road, I'd left the gear they had on here. But no. It was geared pretty low. Almost pulling to work over here. Y'all have a safe, all safe from the coronavirus. Hope nobody there gets sick. Yeah, I did a video a while, but I'll need to start doing some more now. So please like, subscribe, and don't forget to contact Venom Motorsports USA. Use the cost code JerryHawk250 and get an extra $50 off. Later, guys.